practically never heard of. Number 10, Kodiak Island, Alaska. It may get a bad rap here and there due to harsh weather conditions and isolated villages and towns, but there is plenty of beauty to be had in Alaska, especially on Kodiak Island. Separated from the Alaskan mainland by the Shelikof Strait, Kodiak Island is the second largest island in the United States, sporting an area of 3,595 square miles or 9,311 square kilometers. Home to the small town of, you guessed it, Kodiak. Kodiak Island once belonged to the Supiak, an Aleutic nation of Alaskan natives. Today, visitors to Kodiak Island will find an expanse of green vegetation and the majestic Kodiak brown bears that can be observed. Whale watching and fishing are among the many activities for visitors, but six tiny villages with populations ranging from 87 to 224 beg to be explored. Despite the many tragedies that struck, from the eruption of Mount Novarupta in 1912 to the Exxon Valdez disaster in 1989, Kodiak remains a beautiful sight to behold. Number 9. Mackinac Island, Michigan. To step foot on Mackinac Island, you'd think you'd stolen Marty McFly's DeLorean and zapped yourself back to somewhere in the 1850s. Set in the middle of the lake is an island filled with history that dates back to around 900 AD, during which time it was settled by Native Americans. It was the site of two battles during the War of 1812 between the Americans and British, in which the British were successful capturing and defending the island, until the Treaty of Ghent of 1815 forced the British to return the island and surrounding mainland to the United States. Today, the island stands as a peaceful resort area and has a population of approximately 490 people who choose to live there all year. Stop in one of the local shops to pick up a slab or two of your favorite flavors of Mackinac Island fudge. Rent out a colonial-style hotel room at the Grand Hotel. Or check out the original Mackinac Island Butterfly House, where 50 to 60 species make up some 800 individual free-flying butterflies in this 1,800 square feet or 167 square meter exhibit. On Mackinac Island, you can breathe easy, since there are no motorized vehicles here, nor has there been since 1898, when the townspeople banded together and made it law that no personal vehicles are allowed. So, if you want to put Mackinac Island on your bucket list, remember to get your walking shoes on, dust off your Schwinn, and get over your fear of horseback riding. Number 8. Molokai, Hawaii. The state of Hawaii, a part of the United States, is composed of numerous islands, some more notable than others. Among the lesser-known islands of Hawaii is Molokai, or the Friendly Island. Of Hawaii's islands, Molokai is the fifth largest, coming in at around 380 square miles or 984 square kilometers, though only 260 square miles or 670 square kilometers is considered usable. Created through the persistence of three volcanic masses, Kamako, Manaloa, and Kahako, that broke through the Pacific Ocean over 1.5 million years ago. Molokai is thought to have been inhabited around 650 AD by settlers from the Marquesas Islands. Today, it's home to an estimated 8,000 people and houses no building taller than the palm trees. It's an ideal tropical getaway, showcasing the best of the Hawaiian Islands, with a comfortable temperature that teeters between 60 and 80 degrees Fahrenheit or 15 to 26 degrees Celsius all year round. Number 7. Magdalen Islands, Quebec. This archipelago in the Gulf of St. Lawrence makes up a generally unknown aspect of the great Canadian province of Quebec. The Magdalen Islands are made up of Havre-Robert, Grande-Entrée, Cap-aux-Moules, Havre-Maison, Pointe-à-Loup, and Brion Islands, and had once been used by the Mi'kmaqs as part of a yearly harvest of walrus. Seven of the eight islands are inhabited. Brion is currently without residents. The remaining islands are a tourist dream, complete with tourist shops that stock replica molasses barrels to commemorate the winter of 1910. Then residents of the island lost communication with the mainland after a telegraph cable broke. To request help, letters were sealed up in molasses barrels and set adrift for the shore of Cape Breton Island. With the cries for help received, a wireless telegraph system was installed within years to allow for uninterrupted communication during the harsh winters. Number 6. Lamu Island, Kenya. Lamu Island is home to Lamu, Kenya's oldest town, which was believed to be settled in 1370. The island itself may seem a little forgotten by time. Dirt roads connect any of the four settlements found on the island, and trade and travel are done on foot, by boat, or via donkeys. Along with the town of Lamu, Lamu Island is also home to the villages of Shila, Matondoni, and Kipungani, all of which reside at different parts of the island's coastline. Travelers will get to sink their teeth into Lamu's rich history via the Lamu Museum, but also get a chance to sink their toes into the white sand of Shila Beach. Though the island is rustic, it's not without resorts and hotels to attract outside tourism. Number 5. Yakushima, Japan. If you're ever looking to get lost in forestry that is over 2,000 years old, you'll want to add Yakushima Island to your list of getaways. The island, which is approximately 194 square miles or 504 square kilometers, houses around 13,000 people, a considerably low number considering the 1960 headcount of 24,000. But it's not likely the locals that you're wanting to spend your time getting to know. Yakushima is home to a beautiful ancient natural display. While much of the flora and fauna succumbed to logging that ended in the 1960s at the behest of a desire for conservation, a portion of the primitive forest remains standing, and it's likely to be one of the most beautiful natural exhibits you'll experience. Within the original forest is said to be a cedar that may be anywhere from 2,000 to 7,000 years old. Number 4. Oahu, New Zealand. In Lake Wanaka, New Zealand, curious travelers will find Oahu Island, one of two large islands that can be found in the lake. Oahu is a birdwatcher's dream, as the island has been prepped specifically to house endangered avian, with pests like rats and possums removed entirely to allow for the flourishing of these endangered species. Insect lovers will thoroughly enjoy the weta houses, built by a local high school to protect the insects from their abundant avian predators. Besides the weta motels, Oahu is free of human engineering, so don't expect to find a Starbucks. The highest peak, Tirit Peak, stands at 1,552 feet or 473 meters and gives an unobstructed view of Lake Wanaka and the surrounding mountain ranges. A picturesque view if there ever was one. Number 3. Utila, Honduras. It may be one of the smallest islands in Honduras Bay, but Utila has plenty to offer those that venture onto it. An 18-mile or 29-kilometer journey from the Honduras mainland brings tourists to a near 7-mile or 11-kilometer-long, 2-mile or 4-kilometer-wide tropical paradise of Utila. Once the home of the Paya as far back as 600 AD, Utila was involved in a sordid history of slavery and piracy. In 1671, Captain Morgan raided Panama, and it's believed some of his lost treasures sit at the bottom of the waters surrounding Utila, making it a popular diving location. Utila is home to more than 80 diving sites, where experienced divers can get up close and personal with local marine life, including the docile whale shark. One popular dive site is the wreck of the Halliburton, an inter-island transport which was intentionally sunk in 1998 to create an artificial reef for dive training. Number 2. Yap, Micronesia. Traveling to Yap Island in the Federated States of Micronesia is a lot like entering a completely different time. The island itself is actually believed to be made up of four smaller islands separated by small straits of water, but connected by a common coral reef. The indigenous society on Yap uses a caste system made up of seven tiers, and the people of the state of Yap use stone money, or rye, as their common currency. It's a unique world that seems to have little influences from the outside world, and may even be considered a little lost in time. Visitors to Yap Island can partake in snorkeling and diving in the beautiful reefs surrounding the island to get close to manta rays. Despite the simpler life that the people of Yap live, accommodations are available for all sorts of travelers, even those that enjoy the finer things in life. Number 1. Fakarava Island, French Polynesia. We've all heard that Tahiti is a great place to visit, but as so many people know about this large island in the French Polynesia, it may be best to sneak off to somewhere a little less known, such as Fakarava Island. Part of the Tuamotu Atoll, Fakarava offers plenty of history and an environment that can only be described as serene. Some 700 residents call the villages of Ratuava and Tetamanu home, while the rest of the island acts as a sort of ecological preserve for rare birds. Dive sites spread along the coast present an opportunity to catch a glimpse of unique crustaceans.